come out today, that time is up. There's no more giving you lies.
We're not African, we're not black, we're not Jamaican. We're all from the 12 tribes of Israel. And it's the Bible. And it's high time you ain't got a speech. Christianity is a damn thing.
This is reality, we gon' show you why. You have destroyed yourself, bro. So we're supposed to give a warning. We're not judging you, we're warning you.
But have we seen any change?
Yeah.
Have we seen anything that has changed our people? Changed our neighborhood? That is void of
of understanding. Wise men lay up knowledge, but the mouth of the foolish is near destruction.
So destruction is coming for you because when your acts are foolish, you're going against this Bible and you're trying to help you right now.
Yeah.
Your acts are going to increase your demise. Go back to your...
Isaiah chapter 29 and verse 13. Wherefore the Lord said, for as much as this people draw near me with their mouth.
Now actually, if you love God, you say yes, right? So we
and with their lips you honor me.
You say I love God, we
but have removed their heart,
their mind
far from me, and their fear toward me.
Your fear towards God is talked about who?
The precept of men.
That's the only reason you're not putting it out, throwing it in the trash right now.
Right.
Because your fear of God is taught to you by the precepts of men.
Right.
Which is man. It's not going to get you nothing. The Bible tells you everything you need to do.
Wow. Right.
The Romans, the Bible tells you everything that you need to do.
That's right.
So why aren't you, why aren't you taking easy then? Still what? Still human?
Romans chapter
8. Still make mistakes. How does God see you? God see you as human?
Romans chapter 15 and verse 4. For whatsoever thing were written aforetime.
So whatever's written in your history book, read.
Were written for all learning.
It's written for you to learn from.
Right.
So a wise man learns from his past.
Right, that's right.
You understand that? You take the wise man and learn from somebody else's mistakes.
Right.
You shouldn't have to go through the same thing if the Bible tells you, don't do it.
Right. Yeah.
That we, through patience and comfort of the scriptures.
The only reason you're smoking that and drinking that is through comfort. That's comfort stuff. You're trying to make yourself feel better. It's not going to work. Tell me right now, it's not going to work. See?
Might have hope.
And the Bible, God's word, to give us hope. That is going to give you hope. That's going to give you death.
That's right.
What's the wages of sin?
Bring it out.
Wages of sin. What's the wages of sin? Do you have a job? Okay, you ever had a job before? All right, well you... Okay, so you do have a job. When you go on your job and work, what's the wages of your job? Do they give you benefits?
What do they pay you with?
They pay you with what? Money. So the wages of your job is money.
Right.
Right, the payment. So now what's the wages of sin? What do you think it is?
Romans chapter 6 and verse 23.
Bring it up.
For the wages of sin.
And sin is what you're committing right now, right?
Right.
Right? You agree to that, right?
Is death.
You're going to die from that. The payment of your sin, of your actions right now, is death. So why don't you just get up and go down and pray, bro?
Right.
Isaiah 1 and 3.
Listen, bro. Listen, we out here for you, all right?
Luke chapter 13 and verse 3.
Bring it out.
I tell you nay, but except ye repent.
What does it mean to repent? Ask for forgiveness? Yeah. Remember, everything written aforetime was written while I learned, right?
Right.
So the Bible tells you how to repent. And it tells you what repentance is.
Acts chapter 3 and verse 19. Repent!
Repent means what?
Ye therefore and be converted.
What does it mean to convert? Change. Exactly. So, change. Not the actual forgiveness, but the actual stop sinning.
That's right.
So you got to stop what you're doing.
Right.
Right.
That chapter 13 and verse 3.
Yeah.
I tell you nay, but except ye repent, ye shall all likewise perish.
You seen the commercial with the lady with the thing of, there's a smoke, ice, a smoke. And that's gonna be you if you keep doing what you're doing.
Right.
You understand that? You are destroying yourself slowly. But when it comes time, you're gonna die quicker. Because that's a terrible death that you're doing right now. And drinking and smoking is a terrible combination.
Right.
You understand that? So the wages of sin is death. The Bible just told you, except you repent, you are going to die.
Right.
That's the payment of sin.
Right.
Wow. Ecclesiastes chapter 8 and verse 11. Because sentence against an evil work is not executed speedily.
So because Christ will come up and shout, boom, to kill you right now, sin that sin, you don't see other people dying right away, they sin, you think you're getting away with it.
Right.
You're not.
Right.
Therefore, the heart of the sons of men.
What's the heart? The mind of the sons of men.
Is full. It's fully set in them to do evil.
You're doing evil right now, bro. We gotta help you. You're doing evil right now. You understand that? You defile your temple is doing evil.
Right.
Right.
You call yourself human, right? You call yourself human, right? And I say, how does the Most High God see you? Remember I asked you that question, right? So now it's going to tell you. The Bible is going to show you. God's word is going to show you how he sees you. You're his children,
if you're
his children,
God don't
see you, but see you.
Psalm chapter 82 and verse 6. Right. I have said, ye are God.
You are what?
Ye are God.
I'm you.
Ye are God.
I'm a black American.
Ye are God. And all of you are children of the Most High. But ye shall die like men.
You're going to die like a man because you don't want to stop doing what you're doing.
Right.
But the Most High God sees you as a God.
That's right. What?
You are God on the earth. So what God on the earth smokes cigarettes?
Right.
What God on the earth drinks at this time of day? You're not celebrating anything. You're not keeping a high holy day right now.
Right. There you go. Right. It's Rock 31. 25.
All right. I can't hear you, but you got to go.
There you go, that's a precept.
That's it. All right.
25.
Sirach, the book of Ecclesiasticus, verse chapter 31 and verse 29. But wine drunken with excess maketh bitterness of the mind.
You combining alcohol and cigarettes. You're defiling your temple right now.
Right.
With brawling and quarreling, drunkenness increases the rage of a fool till he offends. It diminishes strength.
What?
And it diminishes strength.
You're killing yourself, bro. And you're putting your hand back on. Everything that we told you, the Bible said not to do, you're going against that, bro.
Right.
Bring it on.
Bro, right now, when I ask if you love God, your answer should be no. You don't love God.
Right.
I'll tell you right now, you don't love God.
Right. Right.
I'm telling you straight. This is out of love. I'm telling you straight. Your attention. So when we read before, hold on, I don't mean to cut you off. When we read before, we said, as much as people are near me with their lips, with their mouths in front of me,
right.
Moves their hearts in front of me. That's attention.
Yep.
That's attention. Your intentions are good. But you're not serving God.
Is that first,
right.
First time this.
You understand that?
Talk no more seemingly
apart. John, chapter 1, John. 1 John, chapter 2 and verse 3.
Right.
And here God, we do know that we know him.
So if you knew God, you would be keeping his commandments.
Right.
If we keep his commandments.
You're not keeping his commandments, what does that make you?
he that said, I know him.
And you know him.
Wow.
And you love him.
Right. And keep it not his commandment.
You cover your head back up. You start drinking and you lift that black amount.
Right. Is a liar.
God told you a liar.
That's right.
What you gonna do, brother? God is going to wipe my hands. Throw it away, man. Stop playing with the Most High God. Throw that away.
Read that.
Come on, bro.
Woo. The book of Malachi, chapter 1 and verse 6. A son under his father, and a servant his master.
Who's your master? That's your master, right?
Who's your father?
Who's your father? Okay, so
read it again. A son honors his father. He read that thing. And a servant, his master. If then.
Are you a servant of God? What? So why don't you honor him?
If then I be a father, where is my honor?
Where's God's honor in you? I look at you, I see God's honor. Most High said you are God, but you should die like him, and he's most high said it. But he sees you as a God, so I should see the honor. When I look at you, I should see the honor in you, bro.
Right.
Right now, I don't see it, bro. I see you on the sidewalk, drinking and smoking. You look like the rest of the people out here.
Right.
Man.
You just let that step to dinner.
There we go.
And if I be a master, where is my fear? Saith the Lord of hosts unto you. O priest that despise my name.
You despise thy name in your actions. You might think that you honor God, but in your actions, you despise his name.
Right,
that's right.
Deuteronomy chapter 7 and verse 6.
You know?
For thou art an holy people.
You are special people, whether you know it or not. But you look like the rest of the people out there that's ignoring us like that.
Unto the Lord thy God, the Lord thy God hath chosen thee to be.
You are chosen, whether you know it or not. You are children of Israel. You are chosen.
The Lord thy God hath chosen thee to be a special people.
What's a special people? A special people, Joseph. What does it mean to be special? Huh? Different. What you're doing different. So why you do?
Last scripture right here. Proverbs chapter 1 and verse 24. Because I have called and ye refuse.
So God calls you. We just read scripture to you. You read.
I have stretched out my hand and no man regarded.
No man's gonna save you now. You can't be saved. You can be saved if you change. You gotta change, bro. As long as you're doing that, it's over. You don't die.
But ye have set at naught all thy counsels.
So all the counsel he gave you, all the teaching that he gave you, I told you to do.
And with none of my reproof.
And none of this correction have you received.
I also will laugh at your calamity.
Wait, you went to trouble? No, I'm going to laugh at you. Right, hey, I'm going to laugh right at you. Look, we had the prophets come before you and say, hey, Joseph, stop drinking. Right. Stop smoking.
Right.
I'm covering your head when the scriptures come out.
Right. Right.
You didn't take any of this.
Right.
Before. It's on you now, bro.
That's right.
Joseph.
Named after Christ's father. Joseph. But we gotta go. Yep, start at 17. You're the last teacher point. Go ahead, man. Christ's father. Christ's father's name is Joseph.
Yeah, that's his father's name, Joseph. That's his father's name. Christ's father's name is Joseph.
Right.
A righteous man.
Right.
That's
he,
right.
He runs in the middle of the day, smoking and drinking.
Bring it out. Bring it out.
Ezekiel chapter 3 and verse 17. Son of man, I have made thee a watchman unto the house of Israel.
Watching out for our people. Right. If you watch it out for your health. Because smoking, they say smoking blacks is first for cigarettes.
Right.
And I don't know what you got. You got a natural oxygen, you got a daddy eye, you got a Coke 45, what you got in there?
211.
The worst shit on the planet you can drink.
Right.
Straight to the liver kill you.
Right.
We watching for your health right now. Yeah. Ain't nothing wrong with drinking, but damn, it's the middle of the day. And I guarantee you probably have another drink before the day's over.
Right.
Probably 2 or 3 more. Yeah. Another black, 2 or 3 more today. You ain't doing nothing but killing yourself.
Right.
You watching for your health. You
know? Therefore, hear the word at my mouth and give them warning.
What are we doing?
Give them warning. For me!
That's right. You read the Bible before, right? You read it. And the prophets went out and warned. Repent. Turn away from your sins.
Right.
Stop doing this. Stop doing this. And they didn't do it. And what happened? They got scattered all over the
place. Right.
You didn't listen to God. When the prophets came to him. And you got scattered everywhere. And this is the thing. You didn't go here. You must put on a ship. So you think it ain't that bad. You think it ain't that bad, man. You know, they make it seem worse than what it was. No, you bad as hell. And you're
right.
Still going through it today.
Right.
Read on.
When I say unto the wicked.
Right now, you're straight wicked. You know, I'm going to tell you why you're wicked. Because you ain't even got enough honor and respect for God to even stop smoking while the prophets are reading
right.
The word of God.
Right.
Okay.
Wow. That's straight wicked as hell.
Right.
Not even enough to stop doing that. You've been puffing until the damn thing is gone now.
Right.
And we've been reading the Bible.
Right.
Say you love God, you're a servant, and you're a son of God, I'm a God. You ain't even got enough honor for God to stop while the word's coming out and start smoking and drinking later.
Right.
You've been smoking and drinking right now.
Mm.
God says what?
When I say unto the wicked,
uh-huh.
Thou shalt surely die.
Now see, God's not going to talk to you because God don't talk to the wicked. When you're in the midst of sin, he don't say nothing to you at all.
Right.
You
right.
Know how God talk to you? Right here.
That's right.
That's right.
This is how God talk to you.
Shalom. This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us, subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.